Hello, good evening and welcome to the Feria Valencia in Spain, where, of course, we have just witnessed a Grand Slam Sunday in MotoGP, haven't we? A title deciding Sunday, both in the MotoGP class and in the Moto2 class. And it's time for everyone to get their glad rags on and settle down into a night of celebration after a wonderful season across all the classes in the FIM MotoGP World Championship. The riders are flocking in after a hard day of graft, of course, at the circuit, Ricardo Tormo. This is Sergio Garcia. He, of course, stood on the podium in Moto3. What a year it's been for Sergio Garcia. Just missed out on the title in Moto3, didn't he, to teammate Ethan Guevara. But nevertheless, I spoke to him after the race. He was very happy to stand on the box in front of his home fans ahead of a move up to the Moto2 class next year. And talking of the Moto3 class, well, we've got the champion from last year ready down there with Jack Appiard down on the red carpet. He's speaking to this man on screen, Pedro Acosta. Take it away, Jack. Good evening to you.
And it's a delight to be joined by Dennis Fodger as well. You're enjoying coming here. Obviously, back here last year, I'm sure you would have wanted to return this year with a championship, but still, looking good, looking smart.
Thank you.
You're very welcome, and I'm sure delighted to be here after another successful year, Dennis.
Yeah, thank you, thank you. Back to back, like last year. Yeah, it's special to stay here, all the years, and so I'm really, really happy, proud of my about my championship. It was really, really difficult championship with the KTM, but so I'm really happy about today. Also today it was difficult race, and so in the middle of the championship, I mean, okay, the target is take the top three on the world championship, and so I'm really happy also about the next year.
Absolutely, I'm sure you're excited about next year. Ahead of that, what does the winter time look like for you? What are you going to be doing now?
Yeah, in 1 week I will try the Moto2. Also here in Valencia, and so can't wait for this.
What are you expecting jumping on the Moto2 bike?
I don't know, but I want to go fast as soon as possible.
Absolutely, I'm not surprised. Dennis, thank you very much for joining us. Enjoy the evening, back to back, as you said. Well deserved.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, great to hear from Dennis Fodger. After finishing runner-up in 2021, he of course wanted to come into 2022, sorry, and win the championship, but Gas Aspar in the hands of Ethan Guevara, the world champion, and Sergio Garcia have just been a little bit too strong, haven't they? It's great to see some MotoGP legends in the house, none other than 15-time world champion Giacomo Agostini. He's been in Valencia all weekend supporting all the riders. He's been chatting away to Fabio Quartararo, of course, Pecco Bagnaia as well. I've seen him chatting to Marc Márquez as well. Giacomo, a fantastic guy. Obviously, a glistening career himself and still, looking dapper as ever at the ripe old age of 80, looking very good for 80 years old. And he's just chatting to Franco Uncini. He's retiring as MotoGP safety officer at the end of the season. But I'm sure everyone listening will have seen what's happened today, watched what happened today, enjoyed what happened today at the Circuit Ricardo Tormo. We have crowned the MotoGP world champion in 2022. That is, of course, Francesco Bagnaia. I'm sure we're going to be hearing from him at some point ahead of the riders making their way into the auditorium down here, ready for the FIM awards to get underway. I can see all three bikes on stage that have won the world championships this year. Of course, Ethan Guevara wrapped it up earlier on in the season at Australia, and then Augusto Fernandez claims the title this time around. And I think we can hear from the 2022 Moto3 World Champion, Ethan Guevara, looking very, very dapper, I must say. We did hear he's got a special outfit on, and he certainly hasn't disappointed us. He's down with Jack on the red carpet.
He absolutely is, and what an outfit as well. Ethan, unlike Pecco and Augusto, who have had to make some very last-minute plans, you've had a couple of weeks to plan out the outfit for tonight. It looks incredible. Talk us through it from top to bottom. What are you wearing tonight? Looks good.
Yeah, this is my outfit for this night. Spectacular night for me. First time here, and I enjoy this moment.
Absolutely. And what a season it's been as well. Only your second year in the World Championship, now world champion, moving up to Moto2. If someone would have said in Qatar at the start of the year that you'd be stood here with this suit on celebrating a world championship, what would you have said?
Yeah, I mean, really difficult to start in the championship, but race by race, I good points and recover points with Sergio, and yeah, I incredible victories in Jerez, in the circuits in Spain. I 4 wins in the circuits in Spain. I'm really happy for this season, my first world champion, and yeah, I enjoy this moment, and thank you to all the team for this season.
Absolutely. Let's see what have you got here as well. Talk us through. Oh, this is the championship helmet, right?
Yeah, this is the championship helmet. Yeah, it's incredible.
It is really, really nice. Even got the diamantes on there. Let's see on the back as well. You've got the number 28. The
spectacular.
Really nice. Well done. Good work. The outfit is spectacular. A spectacular season as well. Good luck next year, Ethan.
Thank you. Bye.
That is quite literally a sensational outfit. I mean, he deserves to wear whatever he wants because he's had a sensational season, like Jack and Ethan were saying. 7 wins overall, including today, of course, at his home Grand Prix in Valencia. 4 wins out of 4 in Spain, 12 podiums overall. And like Jack was saying, it's only his second year in the World Championship. So he's won the European Talent Cup, Junior GP title and the Moto3 World Championship in the last 4 seasons. It really has been an incredible run of form for Ethan Guevara, and he moves up to Moto2 next year, doesn't he, as one of the most exciting prospects in the World Championship. Aaron Canet there, walking in with his lovely lady, obviously looking forward to the night ahead. Not the end of the year Aaron would have wanted. He crashed out of his home race here in Valencia, but it's been a good season nonetheless. That Moto2 win still evades him, but going back to Moto3 for a second, the runner-up in 2022 was Sergio Garcia, and I believe Jack can catch him down there on the red carpet. Jack, take it away, mate.
Sergio, we're just talking through plans for tonight's festivities, but that's to come later on. Before that, he's got the important job of getting up on stage as part of the top three in the Moto3 World Championship. Sergio, I'm sure, without a doubt, you would have desperately hoped to have been picking up the World Championship this evening. But overall, on reflection, how do you sort of reflect on your 2022?
I'm really happy to be here. It's the second time here for me. And yeah, it was a really hard season for me. But we work really, really hard to be here, to do second overall. And I think that it's really important to go up to Moto2, and now I'm really looking forward to start to work with the new team, with Sito, and with the new bike.
I'm not surprised. When's the first opportunity to jump on that new bike?
Yeah, gonna be this week in the same circuit in Valencia, and gonna be for sure special.
We just spoke to Dennis. He's jumping on later on next week in Valencia. What are you expecting from the Moto2 bike? Do you think that your style can suit it straight away?
Yeah, for sure. I think my style is really good for a big bike. This is now a real bike. It's really, really fast. And yeah, I think it's going to be special. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to go up to Moto2.
And just finally as well, of course, next year moving to the Pond squad means that you'll move away from Aspar for the first time in a couple of years. We know how much that they look after riders, try to develop riders. Gino, of course, moving on as well. I mean, what can you say about that team environment and how it's progressed you as a rider up to this point?
Yeah, I have to say thank you to Aspar because they gave me the opportunity to be 2 years fighting for the championship. The relationship was good also with my teammate and all my mechanics. But now it's time to think on the next years. I'm really happy to be with Pons. I think it's a really good team to go in Moto2. And yeah, they are world championship. And why not? We can dream on B another time.
Absolutely. Before that, though, a well-deserved silver medal, and I think you definitely have earned yourself a beer tonight as well. Well done, Sergio. A great year.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, he certainly has indeed, Sergio. He took 3 wins this year in Moto3, Argentina, Portugal and Italy. But yeah, like we said earlier on, just lost out on the overall crown to his teammate Ethan Guevara. Now here's a man who's had a very, very good day at the office just off screen there, Augusto Fernandez. It came down to Augusto Fernandez versus Ayagura for the Moto2 crown here at the Circuit Ricardo Tormo. And after Ayagura crashed after getting a very good start, as I'm sure you've all heard about, watched as well, Augusto Fernandez is the 2022 Moto2 World Champion. He, of course, will move into Tech3 GasGas Factory Racing, the new look Tech3 GasGas Factory Racing in 2023. Inea Bassini there walking in. Here's Diogo Moreira, the Moto3 Rookie of the Year, the Brazilian. You can see in the background there, Jack Gorse chatting to Inea Bassini. You can go over to TikTok and watch that behind the scenes on the red carpet with Jack Gorse. But yeah, what a year for Diogo Moreira as well. He's come into the World Championship and really performed to a high standard. He's definitely one to watch next year, is Diogo Moreira. A great kid as well. Lovely, lovely guy to speak to after the races. And he is, yeah, a serious, serious prospect, like many of them are in the Moto3 World Championship. We're going to get some more interviews very soon, of course. The riders coming from the circuit or nipping back to the hotel to get changed. And I think we can hear from the 2022 Moto2 World Champion, Augusto Fernandez. Sorry, Jack, all yours, mate.
Thank you very much, Elliot. Yeah, delighted to be joined by Augusto Fernandez, the brand new Moto2 World Champion. A couple of hours have gone by, Augusto. Is it starting to sink in yet?
Yeah, a little bit. Starting to realize it. Feels amazing. I'm super, super happy. And enjoying it.
Can imagine as well. I just want to know what it was like the first time that you saw your dad afterwards. I know how close that relationship is, having battled through European Moto2 Championships, Stock 600 before that, to get to this point. What was it like sharing that moment with your dad?
Yeah, it was amazing. When I hugged him, I remember every second of our training minutes, our training hours, minutes of struggling there and suffering and putting all the hours possible and all our way till here. So I also saw my mom on the track first with all the celebration with the bunnies, and she was there as well. So yeah, very, very, very happy to have all my family and friends here. This is amazing to be able to share this moment with them. It's awesome.
This is the time to reveal the big secret. Tell us who was behind the bunnies.
One of them was my brother, yes, that is here right now. And the other one was one of my friends that is with a fan club. Them too.
Special moment, absolutely. And of course, Tuesday, not a lot of time to rest. I'm sure you'll have a few drinks tonight to celebrate, well deserved. But then straight to it, MotoGP beckons. I mean, how excited are you for that?
Yeah, another dream coming true on Tuesday. I'm very looking forward to jump on a MotoGP bike and see how it feels and see how it is. And can't wait to work with also the new project, the GasGas project. KTM, I think they've been developing good the bike and they've been improving. They did a very good race today. So looking forward to how the GasGas is and how the project is and everything. So can't wait to jump on the bike.
I'm sure. Good luck for Tuesday and enjoy tonight as well.
Thank you very much. You too, guys.
Yeah, great to hear from Augusto Fernandez and screens pan to Ayagura, who is in good spirits. That's good to see. Obviously, a very disappointing end to his wonderful campaign in the Moto2 World Championship. A couple of crashes, first in Malaysia and then in Valencia. Unfortunately, cost Ayagura the chance of claiming the title, but he'll be back stronger than ever next year, I'm sure. Now, here is a man who has certainly enjoyed the last part of the day. I'm not sure he'd enjoyed all the build-up in the last couple of weeks. Davide Tardozzi, the Ducati Lenovo team manager, spoke to him after the celebrations had partially calmed down. Let's say they're not going to quite calm down for the rest of the night. But let's switch our attention back to Moto2, because I believe Jack has got Ayagura with him.
Not just yet. I'm joined by Diogo Moreira first, Moto3 Rookie of the Year. Congratulations, Diogo. You had to fight hard today. How nice is it to be here at this special occasion?
Yeah, it's special not to be here. And I think we are happy to finish the season like this. And yeah, we make very good races and finish the first rookie. And yeah, let's see next year. We are happy and next to train for next year.
Absolutely. I think one of the best dressed as well. Look at these brand new Jordans that you've got on today.
Yeah, not bad, not.
Brand new, straight out of the box, especially for the awards. Well done, Diogo. Go and enjoy the night.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, great to hear from Diogo Moreira. I'm not surprised he's got a new set of Jordans on. He certainly deserves it. Like I said earlier on, he's had a fantastic year. Here's another one of the Ducati hierarchy, Ducati, of course, sporting director Paolo Ciabatti. Yeah, I was speaking to Davide Tardozzi after the race earlier on, and of course, after 15 years since Casey Stoner won the world title in 2007, who can forget that year? Ducati have finally ended their 15 years of that. They've come so close so many times, haven't they? Of course, Francesco Bagnaia came runner-up last year to Fabio Quartararo, and Andrea Dovizioso treated us to some memorable moments with Marc Marquez, but not all thanks to that man, but largely down to this man on screen, Gigi Delligna. He's created a fantastic motorcycle, hasn't he? A near perfect motorcycle. They will be searching for improvements, of course, but I think now we can actually hear from Ayagura. Jack, down to you, mate.
Absolutely. At last, we've got the Moto2 runner-up Ayagura after a thrilling finale today. I don't know whether to say congratulations after what was an incredible year, some very special moments, or commiserations. What are the emotions like right now?
Of course, after crash, we were quite disappointed, but now we are proud of ourselves and, keep moving forward. So let's keep working for next year.
Absolutely. I'm sure some standout moments for you. The one that comes to my mind, I imagine, comes to your mind as well. That winning Motegi with all the expectation, with Augusto closing you down as well. I'm sure you'll reflect on that over the winter as a special moment.
Generally, it was a nice season. A few victories and a lot of podiums. So we have great memories this year and try to be better next year.
Absolutely, and I know tonight as well, unfortunately, your teammate Somkiat, he does enjoy a party. I remember seeing him in Australia, and he likes a whiskey from time to time. Are you going to join each other and toast a whiskey tonight?
Yeah, we love whiskey, so we're going to have one together, yeah.
Absolutely, you deserve it as well. A great year for both of you. I go and enjoy tonight. I'm sure you'll be back here next year.
Thanks.
A whiskey, I wasn't expecting that. Fair play. Speaking from my own experience with whiskey, I'm not much of a fan, but yeah, Somkiat Chantra and Ayagura, I think probably we'll be having more than one whiskey later on this evening. They do deserve it. Both of them had incredible years. Ayagura just missing out, and yeah, that win in Japan was absolutely sensational. Now, here on your screens, of course, is Fabio Quartararo. Will be disappointed. He was disappointed after the race, as you can imagine. He's put in the hard work this year. He's performed above and beyond what anyone would have expected on an underpowered Yamaha, and both riders deserve the title. Unfortunately, of course, between Pecco Bagnaia and Fabio Quartararo, one did have to miss out, and that is, of course, Fabio Quartararo this time around. Coming behind them in the World Championship, though, was Enea Bassini in third place. He was very pleased after the race to secure third place in the overall standings. I think he is down there with Jack.
He absolutely is. The man third in the MotoGP World Championship, Enea Bastianini. Enea, what a season it has been. Four victories, some in the most special circumstances possible, whether it be right at the start of the year. We saw tears flowing, or even getting the better of Pecco in Aragon. How do you reflect on what has been a memorable season?
Yeah, other special season, I think, and I have a lot of memory about this season, starting from Qatar, no? Because I win my first race in MotoGP, and also was special because it has been the first one for Gresini about many times, and the first one without Fausto, and has been also a little bit so strange, no? But at the end, we have win for other three times, we have made two podiums, and my favorite race is the Cotas. Yeah, Cota hosting for me is something because I like a lot the United States of America, and also the track is, the layout is really strange, and to have win in that track is something special for me.
Absolutely, and third in the World Championship, incredibly important as well. I saw a big smile on your girlfriend's face. I imagine that's because Christmas presents can be a bit more expensive now as a result of that third place.
Yeah, probably, yeah. No, let's see, but, well, today the battle with Aleix is stay sure, no? Because at the second lap I've broken something on the bike, Aleix, and he haven't battled with me, but... anyway, I'm so happy to be there in the third place. I remember I have also a good memory from the 2020, no? Because I win the title, and it's nice to be here.
And just finally, have you tried on the red suit for Tuesday yet?
Yeah, Tuesday. Let's start with this new adventure for me, and I'm really excited to start, and will be difficult, I think, especially at the start, because Pecco win the title, will be very fast from the start. Me, I have to learn something, but I have to push to do the 100%, and I think we can be competitive.
I'm sure you can. You're looking good in blue tonight. I think you're going to look even better in red on Tuesday.
Thank you. Yeah, I like the blue.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah, great to hear from Anea Bastianini. It was an emotional start to the year, wasn't it? Obviously, with the sad passing of Fausto Grassini and the Grassini Racing Team boss, and night in Qatar for the Grassini squad with Anea Bastianini's victory was special. He went on to have a special year, didn't he? He didn't quite challenge the title throughout the year, just missed out along with Aleix Espargaró into the closing stages, but four wins, more than probably most of us would have expected from Anea Bastianini, and looking ahead to 2023. What a year that will be with Anea Bastianini and Francesco Bagnaia on the factory Ducati. Hervé Poncharal, I'm sure a face familiar to all of you, ERTA president and Tech 3 boss. But I think we can hear now from the 2022 runner-up, 2021 MotoGP world champion. That is, of course, Fabio Quartararo.
Yes, we absolutely can. Fabio Quartararo, runner-up in 2022. What are the emotions like seeing someone else put a plaque next to your name later on?
Hey, of course, I would have preferred to put my name close to my name. But let's say, we made quite a good year. We started quite bad. We know that we had a lot of struggle during the year. But finally, you know, to finish in the second place, of course, I would have preferred to finish in the first one, but at the end, I feel pretty happy to be there. And hopefully, next year's bike is going to be much better than this year.
Well, you'll find out on Tuesday. All weekend long, you've been saying that, you know, there's no pressure on me, there's nothing to lose. But honestly, on the grids, ahead of the race, all the media attention, I've never seen a grid busier than it was today. How did you feel?
I feel pretty good, but, you know, with the hot condition, I felt straight away the front tire was way too soft. I could not attack and make any better than that. But, let's say we have to find a solution. Even for that, when we have a struggle with the front, try to improve. And, let's see how we can do it. But I feel we have made a great job in the last two races, some mistakes, but... I think we have prepared pretty well the next season. So hopefully, with my experience, I will have the chance to fight for the victory and the title next year.
Absolutely. Just finally as well, I know in Thailand on social media you created quite the storm by wearing glasses for the first time. I just tried them on and you're actually quite blind. I can't believe that you're able to ride a MotoGP bike. How do you do it?
I'm blind. I cannot see nothing. No, actually... it's not a problem of seeing, it's just a matter of, you know, if I need to read from far, I cannot. So, so to relax, to prepare the party from tonight is quite good. I don't want to be tired before the start.
No, it's going to be a long night, Fabio, for all of us. So enjoy the awards and enjoy drink tonight. You've deserved it.
Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you, mate.
Fabio Quartararo, he certainly deserved a drink or two later on. Three wins, eight podiums. Qualifying didn't go his way, did it, this year? Only one pole position compared to five last year. And ultimately just came up short, but nothing short of sensational from Fabio Quartararo. Jorge Villegas there, the FIM president, walking in. Domenicali there, Claudio Domenicali. He's obviously got a beaming smile in his face, and no wonder, of course, he's just seen his group of team claim the 2022 MotoGP world title that they've all been working so hard for so many years now. They've come up short on a few occasions, like we mentioned. The auditorium is getting busy now, everyone in anticipation for a great night ahead, a great night of celebration. I'm sure we'll get to hear from a couple more. If my eyes didn't see me, I think that was Jorge Lorenzo walking down the red carpet. There's Paolo Simoncelli, Nadia Padovani just behind him in the green suit, Cristini Racing team principal. What a sterling job she's done. Obviously difficult, very, very difficult circumstances at the start of the year with Fausto's passing, but the whole Grassini Racing project can be immensely proud of what they've achieved this year. It was Jorge Lorenzo, my eyes wasn't deceiving me. Of course, the five-time MotoGP world champion, of course, now a MotoGP legend too. We yet to see Francesco Bagnaia, unfortunately. I'm sure he will be in the vicinity very, very shortly indeed. I can confirm the Ducati box celebrations, as you can imagine, were pretty wild. He's obviously been doing a lot of interviews, the press conference as well, where the Ducati team soaked him with champagne, and yeah, it's just going to be a brilliant night of celebration for a lot of people here, but especially the Ducati guys. Like I say, they've been waiting so long for this. And Francesco Bagnaia, of course, in front of Valentino Rossi, the whole 46 Academy crew. Jorge Martinez Aspar, Aspar team CEO, of course, he's had a brilliant season as well. Podiums in Moto2 with Jake Dixon, and the clean sweep in Moto3. World champion with Ethan Guevara, the team's championship and the constructors' crown as well. It couldn't have gone any better for Aspar in Moto3. Not long to go now then before the night really gets underway. Akiayo there strolling in, looking as smart as ever. He's backed his stellar 2021 year with Red Bull KTM Io in the Moto2 class. Remy Gardner, of course, crown champion last year. And this year, of course, it's Augusto Fernandez. Jack Gore still in the background there. Head over to TikTok if you fancy some behind-the-scenes action. But I think most of the people, most of the paddock stars and guests filling into the auditorium, and mostly here now, so we're going to get underway shortly. Do stick around and watch that if you can. I'm sure you're all enjoying your Sunday nights if you're in Europe or wherever you are from around the world. Do hope you've had a fantastic day watching the couple of title deciders. It really has been a fantastic day. Fantastic weather, of course. It's always a little bit of a worry coming to Valencia, isn't it? At this time of year, if we get cold conditions, we've seen it in the past, we're going to be coming later next year, of course. But what a year it's been for MotoGP. 20 rounds. We've had seven winners in the Premier class. Francesco Bagnaia, of course, the new MotoGP world champion. Fabio Quartararo. Enea Bastianini. Aleix Espargaró. That's Lucio Ceccanello, the LCR Honda Castro Idemitsu team manager. He, of course, welcomes today's race winner, Alex Rins, to his project in 2023. Of course, 2023 gets underway in a couple of days' time in Valencia for the Valencia test. You can watch it all live on MotoGP.com. But it is time to now say goodbye. I hope you've enjoyed the build-up to the FIM 2022 MotoGP Awards. Thank you to Jack for the interviews down there. Great to hear from some of the stars of 2022. And yeah, we'll see you, well, we'll see you on Tuesday for the Valencia test where 2023 starts, but we will then have a nice long winter break. The paddock will have a nice long winter break ready for a new season in 2023. So thank you for joining us. Have a great evening or afternoon or morning, wherever you are watching from in the world, and it is goodbye from me. Thank you very much and see you later.
60 kilómetros hora sobre 250 caballos desbocados, buscando los límites del asfalto. El valiente piloto va rezando, soñando, pregando, soñando. Coraggio pilota que sfidi la vita nella tua lotta contro il crono e contro l'asfalto, tutti sul divano saltando, soñando.
You driver, you dreamer, you master, you hero. How great is the feeling after a combat? The glory is your goal. The goal is the prize, just a piece of cloth is the checkered flag.
Frenar más tarde, staccare dai y darle gas, gas a martello. To love your team, a strong engine.
changing. Never say never, we're racing together. With the supporters, noi i tifosi. La grada es en alba, es la séptima marcha. No somos la Magueki, Busele. Testigos de la gloria, de la victoria. Ladies and gentlemen, pronti partenza. This is MotoGP. Silencio. Se rueda.
MotoGP 22 is go.
Et boum, c'est parti pour ce tout premier Grand Prix de l'année.
Welcome to the 2022 FIM MotoGP Awards Ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Alina Marzi and Gavin Emmett, your hosts for this evening's event.
Buenas noches, señores y señores. Buenas noches. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And once again, welcome to the Feria Valencia for the closing ceremony of the 2022 MotoGP World Championship. My name is Gavin Emmett, and with me tonight is my colleague from Servos TV, Alina Marzi.
Thank you, Gavin. Representing BT Sport tonight. Good evening, everyone. It's great to have all of you here tonight for this special occasion. We have an exciting evening ahead of us tonight as we celebrate the end of the season 2022.
Yeah, but before we start handing out the awards, as per usual, it's time to hear from the people who are welcoming us tonight here in Valencia. So please welcome up to the stage with a round of applause the Regional Secretary of Culture and Sport, Chimo López.
Good evening. Buenas noches.
Nice. Thank you.
Buenas nit. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for me to welcome you to the Valencia Grand Prix end of season ceremony. As usual, it's been an exceptional weekend of racing at the Circuit Ricardo Tormo. Once again, Valencia has given us a fitting final to the MotoGP World Championship. We are honored to be lucky enough to finish the season at this venue and hope to maintain this privilege for many years to come. It's an honor for us and a true asset to the motorcycling community. I've been told to be brief because tonight is not our night, it's not our night, but yours, winners and motorcycling fans. So first of all, let me congratulate the champions of the three Grand Prix categories, Ethan Guevara in Moto3, Augusto Fernandez in Moto2, and Pecco Francesco Bagnaia in MotoGP. My warmest congratulations. Furthermore, I would like to thank the presence of Jorge Viegas, the president of the Federación Internacional de Motociclismo, Gonzalo Gobert, Circuit's General Director, and Carmelo Espeleta, Dorna Sports CEO, for their excellent work in the organization of the Valencia Grand Prix and also in the management of Ricardo Tormo's circuit. You've been an enormous help in placing Valencia at the top of the motor racing world. We are indeed delighted to see it, and we look forward to continuing our work together during the coming years, working just as closely and with an equal, if not greater, amount of success. But let me tell you one thing. We have come this far mainly thanks to the Valencian motorcycling supporters and fans. Many years ago, they fought for a circuit and they got it. They fought for a Grand Prix and they got it. They fought for a rider's school and they got that as well. They are one of the most passionate and fervent supporters around the world. So I think that tonight is also their night. Thank you very much. Well, I've said at the very beginning that I was going to be brief, and I'm committed to keep my word. So now it's time to say goodbye. I wish you a great celebration, and I hope to see you all next year in Valencia. As always, we will be delighted to welcome you again. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Lopez.
Yeah, thanks to him. Right, so this year we've got something a little bit new for everybody, don't we, Alina? That's the first time ever. This is a prize where the fans are going to decide the outcome. There are four nominees, four overtaking manoeuvres from the past 12 months, from Valencia 2021 up to Malaysia 2022. Now, MotoGP fans have voted across all of MotoGP's social media channels, choosing which overtake they thought was the best. And during the gala, we're going to see overtakes A, B, C, and D, simple. And we'll reveal the outcome before the end of the show.
And the name of the award is the Agostini Fan Award for the best overtake. So please welcome to the stage the 15-time world champion and MotoGP legend, Giacomo Agostini.
Good evening. Proper legend in our midst. Thank you, Giacomo.
Welcome, Giacomo. I think you can hear it. It's so good to have you here tonight. So the question is, what does this new award in your name mean to you?
Good evening, everybody. I'm very happy to have the possibility to give this award to some very good riders. So I don't know yet who win.
No, well, we don't know yet who win, no. It's going to be a surprise for everybody, Giacomo.
Nobody told me, nothing.
It's a surprise. We will see later, Giacomo.
But it's great, isn't it, to have this award. We are so pleased to have you here tonight, Giacomo. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Grazie.
Giacomo Agostini, a real legend.
Thank you so much.
I'll tell you what, why don't we see... Should we see the first one? Let's see overtaking manoeuvre A.
Let's go.
Vamos a verlo, vamos a verlo. Eran dos pilotos, se mete por el interior y pasa ahí a los dos, les cierra el camino, se queda dentro de la pista, no pisa el verde y es cuarto clasificado. Eres una bestia, Les.
Yeah, absolutely superb. So the first of our overtaking manoeuvres this evening is this wonderful move in the final corner. The Hertimovocht in Assen, Aleix Espargaró on Brad Binder and Jack Miller to take fourth place in the Dutch GP. Fantastic, wasn't it?
Yeah, a real masterpiece. And for sure, we will see other phenomenal overtakes as the evening continues. So now, let's start. First, we'd like to welcome the FIM president, Jorge Viegas, and Mr. Vézier, FIM CCR director, up on stage to present the first award of the night.
Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. Viegas. Good to see you again. Mr. Vessier, good
Hello.
Evening.
Good evening.
Right, we're going to start right at the roots of the sport with the FIM Mini GP World Series Championship. And for the second year, the final took place just a few days ago, right here in Valencia. And the winner of this year's series from Italy is Gabriel Fabio Vuono. Wow, he scrubs up well, he looks good. Gabriel, just 11 years of age and the winner of the Mini GP World Series, so the diploma from Mr. Vessier and that medal around his neck. 11 years old, ladies and gentlemen. Brilliant. Thank you so much, Gabriel. Congratulations. Grazie, Gabriel. Well done. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yeah, now let's move to the Red Bull MotoGP Rookies Cup, the competition that helps many riders to learn and to make the step up to higher level competition, as we can see in the World Championship with many examples.
Yeah, and having scored a total of 4 podiums and 3 other wins this season, the winner of the Red Bull MotoGP Rookies Cup in 2022, Jose Antonio Rueda. Absolutely amazing performance this year from the Spanish rider. He, of course, took the championship in the last race of the season, battling the Dutch rider Colin Veya yesterday. So well done to Jose.
Yeah, many thanks, Jose, but please don't go too far.
Yeah,
that's because Jose Antonio is the first rider to win both the Red Bull Rookies Cup and the Finn Network FIM Junior GP World Championship in the same season.
Yes, for the first time. You think of all the riders who've come through from the rookies and from the Junior GP, the Finn Network FIM Junior GP champion is, of course, Jose Antonio Rueda. So let's give him another round of applause. Amazing achievement. So in Junior GP, he took 5 race wins, as well as another 4 podiums this season. So dominant, brilliant. And he, of course, gets this marvellous trophy as well. Of course, bearing the name of the late Juan Moreta from the Spanish Federation.
A real golden boy tonight, and he's just 16 years old. A good promise for the future, that's for sure. Especially with your debut in Moto3 coming soon. Next year, you will join the Red Bull KTM Tectra.
Yeah, congratulations, Jose Antonio. Well done. Thank you, Jose Antonio. Thank you, Mr. Villegas. Thanks to Mr. Vessier as well. Great to see, isn't it? The fans finally returning to the circuits at every single round and having the opportunity to enjoy our show up close and personal once again. It's been amazing to see so many of you at home there. But that's why we've asked you, the fans, to do your part in this awards ceremony. So, are you ready to watch our second overtaking maneuver of the evening? Here's Overtake B.
Les freinages de Jorge Martin, c'est quand même assez impressionnant.
Miller qui est en position de
défense. Entre les deux virages, dans la chicane, il est allé passer Fabio Quartararo.
Fabio, I think it's fair to say that overtaking was sometimes a real challenge for you and the Yamaha this season. But with that said, it's even more impressive what you have done at the Austrian GP. You managed to overtake Jack Attack with his powerful Ducati during the new chicane, and you get a second place there. I guess that must be a pretty good memory, isn't it?
Yeah, actually, that overtake was quite nice, actually, because, you know, the distance between the turn 2-1-3 was pretty short, and was the only way to overtake them. So I give it a chance, and it works.
Fabio, then, thank you so much for now.
Thank you very much, Fabio Quartararo. Overtake B, that was.
So two more overtakes to go, but for now let's move to the quietest of the categories. It's MotoE. Welcome again, Mr. Viegas and Mr. Vessier. And also, please come to the stage, head of global sponsorship and events at NL, Fabrizio Manni.
Good evening. Thank you very much for being with us. Now, it's just the fourth year of MotoE, but once again, the competition delivered some unforgettable action, and it went right down to the wire at the final round in Misano. So, welcoming him onto the stage, having claimed third place in the FIM NL MotoE World Cup. For the second year in a row, it's Matteo Ferrari. Now, fantastic from Anea, the most experienced Italian in the MotoE World Cup. And that is a jacket and a half, isn't it? I'm a fan of that one.
So next year, maybe you will get that one.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure I could carry it off, but Matteo clearly can. Thank you. Well done. Stay
Thank
on stage
so
with us for a moment, please.
Yeah, with four victories in 2022, the FIM NL MotoE World Cup runner-up is the Brazilian Eric Granado. An amazing job he fought right until the end, so congratulations.
Yeah, a little bit of misfortune in that final round for Eric, but silver medal around his neck. Great stuff. Well done, Eric. Silver medal for Eric this season. Perfect. Right, finally. Yeah, congratulations, Eric. So let's now watch some of the season highlights of the winner of the 2022 FIM NL MotoE World Cup.
What a move from Egerton. Here we go then, the lights are on and they're off.
He's going to try and go right
round
anyway.
The outside, that's how you do it.
So these guys need to be careful.
They're absolutely brilliant. Dominic Egerton versus Mattia Cassadea. Egerton pulls alongside. It's going to be Dominic Egerton, his first win in MotoE of the season.
Oh, fantastic stuff from Dominic Egerton. He timed that to absolute perfection.
Looks like he's going for the lead, but Egerton carves them up all up the inside, parks them in there. Did he just go from P4 to P1, Neil? Egerton wins!
Absolutely spectacular stuff.
Oh, he clips him! He nearly knocks him off, but oh, Egerton! They're neck and neck, they're over! Who's it going to be? I can't believe it! It's got to be Egerton! Oh, wow!
So the winner of the FIM NL MotoE World Cup is Dominic Egerton. Yeah, but for the second year in a row, he's not here with us tonight. So
unfortunately.
Yeah, Jürgen Ling, his team manager, will take the prize in his name.
Yeah, of course, that isn't Dominic.
Dominic achieved 3 victories and 9 podiums out of the Cup's 12 race season. Finally, the Swiss rider wins the title in his 3rd year in the competition.
Yeah, so Jürgen Ling from the team collecting the trophy. Now, of course, while we get the trophy, on Dominic's behalf from Jürgen, it would be the moment, of course, when we'd stand up here and interview Dominic. But instead, he sent us this message.
Hello, everyone. I'm really sorry to not attempt the gala in Valencia. I'm already on the way to Mandalika, Indonesia, where I have the second last race in Supersport. A big thanks to the intact Dynavolt MotoE team to achieve this goal to be champion. It was always my dream to be there. In MotoGP, I was with 17 years now. I hope I can come back in the future. But let's enjoy this evening and yeah, have a great party in Valencia.
Of course, Dominique, talking about the party. That man loves a party.
Yeah, but before we have some work to do, I think so. MotoGP promises to continue the show next year, that's for sure, then with the Ducati brand.
Yeah, Ducati will supply the motorcycles in MotoGP next year when it becomes a world championship as well, which is exciting. Right, we have the next overtaking manoeuvre to enjoy now. So let's see option C.
Uscita veloce importante, ma Bastianini è qui che si allunga un dito, lo tocca. Meglio spettacolo, spettacolo, ingresso spettacolare, spettacolare di Bastianini.
Yeah, I'm, I think we need to check on Sankio after that one. He started in a bit of trouble there. But Anea, we have seen so many close fights between you and Pecco during the season. And again, this one in Aragon brought you yet another win. Just how special, how sweet was that victory for you?
Yeah, it's been really special in Aragon, this victory for me. And we have made a really good battle for all the year with Pecco, but also with other guys. And has been amazing, and it's also my last victory of the year, and yeah, my overtake is not so bad, but also the Fabio's one and the Aleix are so competitive, I don't know.
Hey, it was a good surprise move.
The winner.
We have to wait a bit longer, but anyway, we can't wait to see more of that action next year with Pecco as your new teammate.
Yeah, also Pecco will be my teammate and he's world champion. And I want to say congrats to him. And we will see how is it in the future.
Exciting times ahead of us. Thank you so much, Anea.
Thanks, Anea. Maybe he will beat him in the overtaking manoeuvres. Depends on what the fans have decided. Right, it's time for us to look back now on the 2022 Moto3 World Championship. Of course, it's the first step into the Grand Prix fold. And it's a class that is so competitive that any rider can win any race. We've seen that this season, and with a plethora of new riders trying to make their names stand out. So to award this season's Rookie of the Year, please welcome up onto the stage the ERTA president, Mr. Hervé Poncharal. Good evening, Hervé.
Good evening.
Thanks for being with us. Thank you.
Yeah, and right now, a big round of applause for the Moto3 Rookie of the Year. It's Diogo Moreira. The Brazilian scored a total of 112 points in what was an absolutely stellar first year for him in Moto3. So, congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations, Diogo. Thank you very much as well, Mr. Poncharal. Brilliant season. Absolutely superb. So impressive, wasn't he? He has some bike control, that lad. Right, from the fastest rookie, we now move on to the fastest man on a Saturday with the Tissot Pole of Poles Awards. Now, this is for the rider who took the most pole positions in qualifying this year. MotoGP's official timekeeper and sponsor of this award, Tissot, will be represented tonight by Alina Macias, who I'd like to now welcome up onto the stage. Thank you, Alina. Another Alina.
Yeah, good to have you here. Nice to meet you.
Thanks for being with us. Thank you.
Hi. So it was an extremely tight one this year, but the winner of the Tissot Pole of Poles in Moto3 with 5 pole positions is for sure the world champion. It's Ethan Guevara. Yeah, Ethan now receives a watch from Ms. Macias following a closely fought battle for the prize for fastest qualifier in Moto3.
Yeah, congratulations, Ethan. Thank you very much. We will see you very soon, I think. Thank you, Ms. Macias, as well. Thanks for being with us. I think we'll see Alina back on stage as well. I'd like to invite back onto the stage Mr. Frank Bessier, of course. He's going to present to us. He's going to present the Moto3 Team World Championship Award. So if Mr. Bessier wants to come back up onto stage.
The award for the best team in Moto3 goes to GasGas Aspar. Jorge Martinez Aspar receives the award from Frank Bessier. What a performance from the GasGas Aspar team with 10 wins as well as 12 podiums from the riders Izan Guevara and Sergio Garcia.
Yeah, congratulations, Aspar. Thank you, Jorge. 1-2 in the championship. Thank you very much. Thank you. Frank, you stay with us, Mr. Bessier. So, Mr. Bessier is going to stay with us because now it's time to award the Constructors World Champion in Moto3. And it's been a really close fight, actually, between the Moto3 manufacturers this year. And the winner was decided back in Malaysia.
Yeah, but the 2022 Moto3 Constructor Champions in Moto3 are GasGas. A big round of applause for the Spanish factory. Christian Kontner, KTM head of Moto3, collects the award.
Yeah, well done, Christian, and well done to GasGas too. Their first Grand Prix championship, and for 22 podiums in 2022. Thank you as well, Mr. Bessier, and thanks to Mr. Kontner.
Yeah, let's welcome back FIM's Mr. Viegas back on stage, because now it's time to meet the best Moto3 riders of the season. Yeah, and we will start with Dennis Fortscher in third place.
Yeah, so Mr. Viegas, welcome back onto stage. Good evening again. And let's welcome on stage Dennis Fortscher. There he is. I could see him backstage. I knew he was there. So Dennis, for third in his quest for glory, a real crowd favourite, and we expect big things for him to come. Of course, moving to Moto2 next year, Dennis, and takes that bronze medal this year. Another great season. Congratulations, Dennis. Thank you. Stay with us, please.
Yeah, because we will continue to present the prize for the runner-up. The Moto3 runner-up is Sergio Garcia. That was an impressive season from the Spaniard. Sergio took 3 wins and 7 further podiums on his way to second in the lightweight class. Next, we will see him in Moto2 as well.
Yep, he's going up there next year. Right, also, yes, Sergio, please stay on stage with us now because we are going to move on to the Moto3 World Champion, Alina. I do believe it's the time for that.
It's time for that right now.
Where go here in the Red Bull Grand Prix of Spain? Around the outside goes Izan Guevara, and it looks like the pole man, Izan Guevara, reigns in Spain. He wins an absolute classic. Izan Guevara has been docked a penalty. Oh, they can't believe it. That's the end of Izan Guevara's Grand Prix. That's a beautiful move by Izan Guevara, just moving up the inside. It's glory for Guevara here. He wins the Monster Energy Grand Prix of Catalunya. Izan Guevara is your race winner here in the German Grand Prix. The world championship leader, he rubs elbows with Suzuki. Through the ramshackle corner they go. Guevara does take second place. He's the master of Motorland. And here goes Guevara on the inside. It has been a Motegi masterclass from world championship leader Izan Guevara.
Absolutely fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2022 Moto3 world champion, Izan Guevara.
Josh Viegas hands over the awards and diploma to Izan, who took the title in Australia with an amazing victory. Finally, Izan takes the championship with 7 wins and 5 further podiums. An amazing job.
Yeah, absolutely superb. Brilliant, Izan. If you all could come together, all three, if you could come up the stage, please, because we want to get a quick photo of our Moto3 World Championship trio. Brilliant stuff. Huge round of applause for these three fantastic young riders in Moto3.
Thank you so much. But please, Izan, stay with us.
Izan, you stay on stage with us. we can say goodbye to the rest of them because, Izan, a fantastic season for you. Your second season in Moto3. What was your secret this year to making the step and becoming the champion?
No, the key this year is my pace alone. Work alone in the FPs and yeah, in the race I push always for good race.
Yeah, and there were a lot of good races, seven wins, including today in Valencia. Congratulations, Ethan.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our Moto3 world champion, Ethan Guerrero. So, before we carry on, we have to see our final overtaking manoeuvre of the evening. So, please, roll VT on option D.
There we go, the inside. Oh, that's tight in there. Pecco Bagnaia is thinking, Quartararo's out of this race. I could almost win this championship today.
I almost lost my voice there as well.
So last but not least, it's Pecco who brings us one of the best overtakes that season. Looking back to one of the most exciting races this season in Australia, you managed to get in front not only of Marc Marquez, but also Jorge Martin. What makes that move so special for you, Pecco?
It was great. I think it's one of the best overtakes of this season from me. And I seen that Rins was overtaking and he was fast, so I understand that it was important to follow him, so I tried to overtake Marquez, but then I see that it was possible to overtake also Martin, so I tried. But I don't know if we'll be in the same level of the overtakes of the others, so let's see.
We will see. Thank you very much. It was a fantastic race anyway. Anyway, thank you so much, Pecco. Congratulations. And having seen all those four now, in a few minutes, we are going to find out who is the first winner of the Agostini Fan Award for the best overtake. And this year has been full of overtaking manoeuvres and plenty more besides. Yeah, I can't believe it's over.
Many emotions we had lived through this season. Equally so in the Moto2 World Championship that was also truly remarkable this year, with excitement right to the very end, a duel for the ages between two fantastic riders, both destined for great things.
Yeah, so please welcome up onto the stage five-time world champion and MotoGP legend Jorge Lorenzo, who's going to present to us the Moto2 Rookie of the Year Award.
Good evening, Jorge. Great to have you with us. Great to see you.
Good evening.
Jorge himself, of course, was Rookie of the Year in his debut season in MotoGP, so he knows exactly what this award means. And the award for this year's Moto2 Rookie of the Year is, of course, Pedro Acosta. Yeah, brilliant. Another victory as well today for Pedro. Absolutely fantastic. Huge round of applause, please. Yes, for Pedro Acosta and, of course, Jorge Lorenzo as well. Thank you to Jorge. Three wins, two podiums this year. An impressive season, definitely, for Pedro Acosta. Yeah.
Yeah, and we now move on to the award, the top Moto2 qualifier of the year with the Tissot Pole of Poles. Alina Macias, please come back to us on stage.
Thanks again, Alina, for being with us.
And the best qualifier this year is Aaron Canet. and it has been very disputed this year until yesterday.
So, Alina, handing over the prize to Aaron, a total of 3 pole positions this season. Well done, Aaron, and thank you again, Miss Macias. I was half expecting a wooden bow tie. Thought it might come out.
And we asked Mr. Vizier to join us on stage again, because now it's time to award the prize for the best team. They say talent wins races, but it's teamwork that wins championships, such as the important role of teamwork in Grand Prix racing.
Yeah, that is so true. The best team in Moto2 this year demonstrated it in abundance. The winners are, of course, Red Bull, KTM, Ayo.
A sensational performance from the team. In total, 7 wins from the 2 riders, Augusto and Pedro. Aki Ayo collects the diploma from Frank Vezier. Congratulations.
Yep, Mr. Vezier, yep, you stay on stage with us. And thank you to Aki also. Because from teams, now we move on to machinery to award the top Moto2 constructor. And the winner of the trophy in 2022 is, once again, Kalex.
Collecting the diploma is Kalex Managing Director Alex Baumgartl, who has been there to collect the award for the last 10 years in a row.
Pretty special stuff, isn't it? Congratulations. Thanks, Frank, as well. Thanks, Mr. Vesier. Right, we're moving along rapidly, aren't we? We're getting there. But now we're going to invite Mr. Viegas. If you could join us back up onto the stage, thank you very much. It's time to award the top 3 Moto2 riders. And we're going to begin with third place. This year in Moto2, that trophy belongs to Aaron Canet.
Jörg Viegas presents Aaron with the bronze medal. He achieved 8 podiums and scored 200 points.
Thank you very much, Aaron. Please stay with us, yeah.
Yeah, Mr. Viegas, please stay with us as well, as we now move on to the Moto2 runner-up. The silver medal goes to Ayo Gura.
Yeah, fantastic season for Ai. He came oh so close, and your heart broke for him today. 7 podiums this season and took that title chase right down to the wire in scintillating fashion. And thank goodness he's okay after that big crash today. Congratulations, Ai. Please stay with us now as we present to you all the Moto2 World Champion.
He's run wide. Oh! Can you believe it? Wow, what a final corner. Augusto Fernandez wins the 2022 French Grand Prix in Moto2. Dixon loses third place into turn 12 from Augusto Fernandez. Warm welcome to the Sachsenring in Germany. That was really aggressive.
He's leading now over 6 seconds.
Fantastic Fernandez. He wins in Assen for the second time in 7 days. Fernandez will lead the Moto2 World Championship. He just squeezes on the inside of Alonso Lopez. He wins an absolute classic Moto2 race.
That's a great move.
Welcome back to Motorland Aragon, round 15. Augusto Fernandez then does take third.
Here comes Fernandez then. He needs to make progress quickly.
And that's one place game. Oh!
Our 2022 Moto2 World Champion is Augusto Fernandez.
Yeah, congratulations to Augusto. 4 wins and a further 5 podiums. A blockbuster championship-winning season. And, of course, he'll make his debut in MotoGP in just 2 days' time. And also next year, of course, he'll be here taking the MotoGP Rookie of the Year because he will be the only one moving up. Congratulations, Augusto. If you could all 3 just stand forward a touch for the photo. Our top 3 in Moto2 this season, Aaron Canet, Ayo Gura and Augusto Fernandez. Aaron, I, Mr. Viegas. Thank you very
much. Thank you so much.
Aaron, I also, Mr. Viegas, will say goodbye. Augusto, please stay with us now, because Alina would like to ask you a question.
Yeah, we should have a word. Augusto, today a dream came true, moments to keep for a lifetime. Can you just realize what you did today?
Not yet, honestly. Step by step realizing it's a dream come true. It's been an amazing year. I want to thank all my team for all the year. It's been amazing to work with you guys, and yeah, super happy to be here and looking forward also to jump on the MotoGP on Tuesday. So dream is going on, so yeah, super happy.
A lot to do in just 2 days, so enjoy the evening. Congratulations to a pretty strong season.
Yeah, thank you very much. Truly fantastic this year, Augusto Fernandez. Right, it's time for the MotoGP prizes now. And as we promised before, it's time for us to find out the results of the new award, of course, which has been decided by you, the fans at home. Remember, it was a selection of overtaking manoeuvres between Valencia 2021 to Malaysia 2022. And the fans, as I say, have voted on MotoGP's social media channels. Please welcome onto the stage Sergio Rodriguez. Now, he's a content creator, but perhaps a lot of you know him a little bit better as Dios Miller Oz and his creation of Viva Miller, of course. Yeah, he's representing our fans tonight, and he's going to hand over this brilliant new prize, the Agostini Fan Award for the best overtake.
So let's remind you to the four riders' overtakes. It's Aleix Espargaró at the Dutch GP. We have Fabio Quartararo at the Austrian Grand Prix, Enea Bastianini at the Aragon GP, and the final one, Francesco Bagnaia at the Australian GP. And the winner of the first ever Agostini Fan Award for Best Overtake is Fabio Quartararo. Hey. Fabio, please come on stage with us. Seems like there are a lot of Fabio fans out there. Team Fabio did a pretty good job on that.
Brilliant stuff. Yeah, fantastic move at the Austrian Grand Prix. Ladies and gentlemen, what a move that was. Fabio, and thank you very much, Sergio, as well.
Thank you so much to the both of you. Yeah, and I can't wait to see even more exciting overtakes next season.
I want some more memes as well off Viva Miller, definitely. Right, let's continue with the prizes in the premier class of MotoGP. Now, there's a rider who's impressed enormously in his first year in the category, right from the get-go. The MotoGP Rookie of the Year Award is an accolade in memory of the late Marco Simoncelli. And so, to present the award, as every year, we'd like to welcome his father, Paolo, onto stage with us. Buonasera, Paolo.
Good evening.
Thank you for being with us. Grazie. Thank you.
And the 2022 MotoGP Rookie of the Year is Marco Bezzecchi. He achieved a brilliant podium in Assen and a pole position in Thailand as well, and next year he will be back to fight even more.
Yeah, brilliant. That's fantastic, isn't it? Paolo, Marco, thank you so much. Congratulations. Thank you. Well, what an honour to Marco Simoncelli that is, with Marco Bezzecchi, the new school, the new breed. It's now time for our third Tissot Pole of Poles Award of the night for the fastest qualifier in MotoGP. So please, Alina Macias, if you want to join us onto stage, of course. And in MotoGP, this is named in memory of the late Niki Hayden also.
And for the second time in a row with five pole positions, the Tissot Pole of Pole winner is Francesco Bagnaia. Alina Macias presenting Pecco with his watch.
Thank you very much, Ms. Macias.
But Pecco, I think you can stay here with us.
Yeah, Pecco, you can stay. You can stay with us. Maybe you can hand the watch over to Belen there. Thank you very much. Yeah, because you are going to receive your first BMW M. Well, I don't know, you might have one at home already, but the first one that you're going to be given, because of course it's given to the MotoGP rider with the most qualifying points in a season. We've got Timo Resch, the Vice President Customer Brand Sales at BMW M. He's going to join us. Thank you very much, Timo.
So Pecco receives now the keys for his gorgeous BMW M3 Touring. For sure he will enjoy the car.
I think he'll do all right with that. Thank you, Mr. Resch. Congratulations, Pecco, please, thank you. Thank you very much, grazie.
See you later.
We'll see you in a bit, I think.
Yeah, right now let's continue with the best independent team for this year. So please, Hervé, join us again.
Yep, Hervé Poncherel, of course, the IRTA president, will join us up onto the stage. I can see him, there he is, with the trophy in his hand. So this year, the trophy goes to Prima Pramac Racing. Paolo Campinotti then, of course, receiving the award. Ciao, Paolo. Good evening. Receiving the trophy. Hervé, please, pass the trophy. Don't hang on to it. an excellent job this year. 8 podiums with Joan Zarco and Jorge Martin. Thank you very much, Hervé. Thanks, Paolo. Congratulations.
Yeah, but I think Hervé can stay with us.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
but Hervé?
Chaps, Hervé, Paolo, come back as well.
Yeah. So now from the best independent
and
team.
Paolo.
To the best rider from an independent team this season. The best independent rider in the 2022 MotoGP is Enea Bastianini.
Good evening, Enea. Well done. Best rider from an independent team. An impressive, that first victory in Qatar and fought hard for third position in the championship. Just his second year in the Premier Class. Huge congratulations to Enea. Thanks, Mr. Poncherel, and thanks to Enea too. Well done.
And we welcome again Mr. Vizier to present the award for the best MotoGP team of 2022. Points picked up by the riders of each team in this extraordinarily close season.
Yeah, it has been so close indeed. And the award this year, when we finally have someone up on stage to hand out the award. Mr. Vessier, come on, please join us up on here, because the award goes to, of course, Ducati Lenovo team. Collecting the award here, Paolo Ciabatti. And, of course, a key part, Paolo. Great season for the team. A whopping total of 454 points, including 8 wins. Thank you, Paolo. Mr. Vessier, you can stay with us on the stage.
Let's talk about the manufacturers that make the spectacle more competitive than ever before. The 2022 MotoGP Constructor World Champions are Ducati, their 3rd title in a row.
And of course, collecting the award from Mr. Vessier is Luigi Dallinia, Ducati Corse General Manager. Ducati scored a podium in every Grand Prix and ended up with 448 points. An amazing performance from the Italian constructor. Thanks, Mr. Vessier. Congratulations, Gigi. He's not one for the cameras, is he?
Yeah, and it's getting serious right now,
I think. Getting to the business end of things, yeah.
The FIM president, Jorge Villegas, rejoins us on stage because now it's time for us to hand over the prizes to the top 3 riders in the MotoGP World Championship this year. Let's see who's the 3rd.
The beast reigns supreme in the Middle East. Hail the new King of Qatar. Well, can you believe it? Bastianini's gone down again. Here comes Bastianini. Bastianini. Oh, how close was that? It's the beast that wins a classic here in Motorland Aragon.
The 3rd place goes to Enea Bastianini. The Italian is awarded with the bronze medal from Mr. Villegas after a season in which he scored 6 podiums.
Enea, don't go anywhere. We want to have a quick word with you. Please, come forward here to have a quick word, because when you joined the Gresini team, new with Ducati for them this year. Of course, you've been there on last year's Ducati. Did you expect you were winning the first race of the season and finishing up 3rd in the championship?
No, my expectation was not too high, no, at the start. But when we arrived in Qatar, but also during the test, we was competitive, and I think, okay, my target can be a little bit more high. And we have win the first race, and after we have make other three race, three victory, two podium, and I want to say thanks a lot for this opportunity from the Gresini team. Thanks to Fausto, and also
absolutely.
Thank you. And also to Nadia for this amazing job, no?
Yeah, an amazing job from you, Nadia, the whole team. It was so emotional. Congratulations, Anea, on your season.
Thank
well
you
done
so
on third place.
Thank you.
Yeah, please stay with us, the both of you, as we will now present the award for the MotoGP runner-up.
He might be having a look in Joan Zarco.
Oh, a brilliant podium. Really good second place there for Fabio Quartararo. Quartararo's got the inside line, slipstreaming on the Yamaha. It has been picture perfect in Portugal. Conquers the Catalan Grand Prix. A truly dominant performance by the reigning world champion. Paul Bagnaia did get through, and Quartararo back in front. Quartararo wins the German Grand Prix. Oh, brilliant by Fabio Quartararo. I mean, he's in second place.
Yeah, the runner-up in MotoGP this year is the outgoing champion. Please give it up for Fabio Quartararo. Yeah, he might not have been able to retain the title this year, but he did maintain that pressure right until the end. Three brilliant wins, five podiums this season on top, enjoying those victories in Portimao, Montmeló and at the Sachsenring. Runner-up in MotoGP for the first time, and the silver medal around his neck. Alina, I think I'll let you have
it's
a word with Fabio.
It's time for a quick talk. Fabio, I know you're already concentrating on Tuesday, thinking about the next season. I know it's not the ending of the season you were hoping for, but overall, it was a pretty good time for you. A strong performance. You managed to come back as high as the challenge was. So are you able to see the good things right now of the season?
Yeah, of course, it's tough to see the positive things of the second part of the season. Was an up and down season for us, but I guess was a lot of experience. We had some really good races, some wins, some podiums. But you know, my goal for next year is to step up like last year. I'm sure Yamaha is working super hard to make it, and yeah, a lot of experience, good races, and of course, congratulations to Pecco, because the second part of the season was really strong, but here we are next year to fight for it.
We are really happy to hear that you're more motivated than ever. Thank you, Fabio. Please stay on stage with us.
Yeah, Fabio, congratulations. Fabio's going to stay on stage with us now, because it's time for us to crown the MotoGP World Champion.
Yeah, this is the moment that we have all been waiting for. Time for the new MotoGP World Champion to add his plaque to the Champions Tower. First of all, let's have a look at some highlights from yet another phenomenal season.
You very, very rarely see Pecco Bagnaia mistakes.
Oh, Pecco Bagnaia's crash! Can you believe it?
Brilliant, Bagnaia. He reigns in Spain, but the Catalan wins the Red Bull Grand Prix of Spain. And look at this, Fabio Quartararo is going to get absolutely swamped. He is the master of Mugello in 2022. Bagnaia has been the top man in this Aston Grand Prix. And Dutch TT winner is Pecco Bagnaia. Has this British Grand Prix covered? It's been an absolute classic. Pecco Bagnaia wins at the Red Bull Ring in Spielberg. Here comes Bastianini. Bastianini, close with that.
In four races on the spin.
Bagnaia is your winner here in the Malaysian Grand Prix.
Yeah, A huge round of applause and perhaps more singing for the 2022 MotoGP World Champion, Francesco Pecco Bagnaia. Absolutely stunning performance from the Italian. His first title, recovering that 91 points to Fabio in the championship.
As Mr. Villegas presents Pecco with his World Champions medal, please give a warm welcome, Mr. Carmelo Ezpeleta, Dorna Sports CEO. Mr. Ezpeleta will bring the new plaque to add to the MotoGP World Champions Trophy.
Yeah, so if Mr. Ezpeleta, if he could hand the plaque over to Pecco, it's time now for Pecco to add his first plaque to the Champions Tower. Yeah, that's right. Let's see. He got the season amazing, 265 points, 7 victories, those amazing 4 in a row, and World Championship honours back to Ducati after 15 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Pecco Bagnaia. A huge thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ezpeleta and Mr. Villegas. Pecco, Fabio, Enea, please come to the forward part of the stage to stand together for our photo, our top three in the 2022 MotoGP World Championship. What a season they've given us. Enea Bastianini, Fabio Quartararo and Francesco Bagnaia. Pecco, you stay with us. Fabio, Enea.
Thank
Enea,
you so much.
You can go with Fabio and return to your seats.
And finally, he touched the trophy.
He finally touched it because, of course, you didn't want to touch it before the weekend. But now I think you're allowed to. Pecco, it's been an incredible season. But it will be remembered more than anything for that amazing comeback that you did. 91 points behind. Did you truly believe at that stage of the season that this moment here in front of the trophy was possible?
Sincerely, I just lose my faith on it like 1 hour, 2 hours after Sachsenring. But after that moment, I tried to see the way to find the way to be better, to improve myself, to analyze why I was crashing, why I was doing so many mistakes, and sincerely, I'm very proud of my team, very proud of the people working on track, the people working at home for us. It's unbelievable. I'm very happy. Also, I'm very proud of myself for what we did. It's an unbelievable moment.
It's an incredible achievement, isn't it? The stats say it as well. It's the first Ducati win in 15 years since Casey Stoner, the first Italian since your mentor, Valentino Rossi, and the first Italian on an Italian bike since the legend sat down there, Giacomo Agostini, 50 years since that happened. All those things together, what does that mean to you?
When I was young, I was looking at TV and I, for sure, cheering for Vale. And when I saw that with Ducati Vale didn't had his feeling, didn't have the possibility to win the title. So I was sad, really sad, but because I was a really great fan of Vale, but also a great fan of Ducati. So when I received the call of Gigi, when he said to me, "Okay, next year you will be the factory rider next year." It was a dream, a big dream for me. And finally, after 2 years, had this possibility of fight for it with problems. I had mistakes. I crashed a lot of times. We had problems. So didn't go so well all the year. But this comeback was incredible. And I have to say thanks to them for what they give to me, to the support they demonstrate to me. So was incredible. I had to say thanks to Ducati, thanks to the academy, thanks to my family, thanks to my girlfriend. It's very a beautiful moment for me.
It is for all of us as well. Ladies and gentlemen, our MotoGP world champion in 2022. Impeccable, I think you'll say. Pecco Bagnaia. Thank you very much, Pecco. Thank you. Enjoy the evening.
Our new MotoGP world champion. But great champions in all classes getting a fitting send-off here in Valencia. And to add the final touch to the evening, we now welcome back the FIM president, Jorge Villegas.
Thank you. Good evening. I don't know how to start. We had finally a normal year. You saw today in Valencia. And this is one of our objectives is to work for the spectators. And we had a big crowd, a happy crowd. And we had this year the second season of the Mini GP. A great, great success. Who had the fortune to go last Thursday to see the young boys, and I hope in the future girls also, you saw how they behave. Then we had another incredible season in Moto3. By the way, MotoGP is more and more looking like Moto3, this I like. And Moto2, the title was decided today. And finally, we had a big, big battle in MotoGP. So what else? I keep saying, we have the best sport in the world. Have a good night. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much to Mr. Villegas.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks very much. No, but it's okay.
Thank you.
No.
You did a great job.
Thank you very much, Jorge.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So thanks to Mr. Villegas and all of the other dignitaries who handed out the trophies here this evening in the Feria Valencia. And of course, thanks to all of our champions too, Elena.
And the 2023 kicks off this Tuesday with MotoGP testing here in Valencia. A lot of new riders with new teams. And an amazing 2023 calendar with two circuit and country debuts. It's Kazakhstan and India, and a new season opener in Portimao on the 26th March.
Yeah, that is going to be fun at the roller coaster at the end of March. Thank you to everybody here and everyone at home as well for joining us this evening. It has been a real pleasure to be with you, and thank you to you, Alina, too.
Thank you so much, Kevin. It has been a real pleasure and an absolutely stunning 2022. So right now, it's all to say goodbye and good night. Bonne nuit.
Good night.
The moment we've all been waiting for has finally arrived. It's lights out and lift off for MotoGP in 2022 in Qatar. Friendly fire. I can't believe it. What an emotional victory for Andrea Bastianini.
Who will be the rainmaster?
Miguel Oliveira snaps up the inside, but Miguel is the man in Mandalika. Today is your day. It's time to tango in Argentina. Alexis Fargo and Aprilia celebrate their first ever win in MotoGP. The 500th Grand Prix.
Here he goes.
All hail the new King of Kota.
New leader of the championship.
Star for Dranmir. Miller on the front end. But here comes Fabio Quartararo. It has been picture perfect for the reigning world champion.
Fans back at the Circuito de Jerez.
At the moment, it's a two-horse race between Pecco Bagnaia and Fabio Quartararo. Here comes Aleix Espargaró. Brilliant, Bagnaia. He reigns in Spain. Aleix Espargaró does take a stunning podium.
Fabio.
He goes straight past his teammate, Luca Marini, into the lead.
This is another stunning ride by the reigning world champion. Pecco Bagnaia, he is the master of Mugello. For the Battle of Barcelona.
Oh, contact!
Has been won. Alex Rins of Pecco Bagnaia, sorry, has been taken out. Oh my goodness, can you believe it? He thought the race was over. Fabio Quartararo conquers the Catalan Grand Prix. Round 10 here at the Saxon Ring. Quartararo will sweep up the inside of Bagnaia then in P1.
Oh,
Pecco Bagnaia has gone down. Quartararo wins the German Grand Prix.
Quartararo now attacks.
Oh, he's down! Oh no, Fabio Quartararo's gone down! What a move this is. Big, big race for Aleix Espargaró. Our Dutch TT winner in 2022 is Pecco Bagnaia. Close with that, 300 of a second between Pecco Bagnaia and Andrea Bastianini at the finish line. Pecco Bagnaia, the first Ducati rider in history to win four races on the spin. The king is back. And lights out, away we go here in Motorland.
Oh, he's gone down! That's
Quartararo! Oh, Fabio Quartararo has been collected mid-pack. Is it going to be Bastianini or Bagnaia? It's the beast that wins a classic on the last lap again. Oh, Aleix Espargaró, what is happening here? We've lost the man third at the end of the warm-up lap. Miller's gone for it on the inside. Jack Miller's been superb.
Oh, Bagnaia!
Miller magic in Motegi. Whose destination is the top of the podium here in Bahrain?
Just four races remain in the chase for the title.
Quartararo started fourth. He came through 7-2, 17. Rain masterclass from Miguel Oliveira. Pecco Bagnaia does take a super important third place. Second for Miller.
I'm still alive, mathematical. I'm a dreamer.
Not a great stop. He's made a big mistake. Unfortunately, Jack Miller's world title hopes are ended. Rins wins in Australia. Awesome job by Marc Marquez. His 100th MotoGP podium. Pecco Bagnaia take over the lead of the MotoGP World Championship. Pecco Bagnaia up into second place. Fabio Quartararo clinging on to that third place. How close was that? Bagnaia is your winner here in Sepang. It's all down to the final Grand Prix.